idea, busy people. So we are going to the revision session for Genki textbook. Okay, this is the Genki one, Aisatsu. I think you will be very, very familiar with this Aisatsu, that is greetings. These are the survival phrases in Japan. Okay, when you go to the Japan, if you are telling Ohayo or Ohayo gozaimasu, the people will feel very happy really, because you are learning their language and you are replying in their language. Because wherever the country, if you speak their own language, the other people will be so happy to reply. Okay? Okay, my dear friends, let's begin with the good morning. The good morning is Ohayo gozaimasu. So Ohayo gozaimasu is a very formal way of telling good morning. Ohayo, this is for friends and family. A very casual way of telling good morning. Okay? Ohayo, good morning. Ohayo gozaimasu, good morning. So both is good morning, but when you are on a first name basis, then go for a lengthier versions. First name basis means, so the Japanese people will have two names, first name and last name. They don't have the middle name at all. So actually the first name basis means you are talking to the person as, calling the person as San. Not like, for example, my friend name is Yamada. So Yamada. I can't call him Yamada in the beginning. I use it to call him Yamada-san. Now in the recent times I am calling him Yamada. Because but the very first beginning I am strange to him. So I call him Yamada-san. In that cases you have to go with longer versions or lengthier versions. If you are very familiar and you are very close friend, then you have to go for shorter versions. That is the very important and useful clue. Coming to the first, Ohayo, good morning. Ohayo gozaimasu, good morning. So while telling the Aisatsu greetings, you just bow a little bit, and if you tell means, which make the people to understand that you are respecting. Bowing is very common in Japan. If you are bowing, the degree of bowing will tell you how much of the respect you are paying to others. So just bow a little and tell Ohayo or Ohayo gozaimasu. Konnichiwa means good afternoon. Konnichiwa means also hello. Actually, hello is used in many cases. So without telling the Ohayo or Konbanwa, you can just simply tell Konnichiwa. Konnichiwa o genki desu ka, which means hello, how are you? Or like konnichiwa hishashiburi desu, hello, long time no see, hishashiburi desu. Hishashiburi desu means long time no see. So konnichiwa is very common, but you don't have a separate phrase for good afternoon. So konnichiwa means good afternoon. Konbanwa, good evening. Kon means this. Ban, evening. Konbanwa, good evening. So there is no any casual or formal phrase for good evening. Simply konbanwa. But yoru. Yoru means night. Don't forget this. Asa, morning. And hiru, afternoon. Ban, evening. Yoru, night. Okay. So these are the things for morning. Day, morning, afternoon, evening and night. Let me repeat it one more time for you. Asa, morning. For afternoon it is hiru. For evening, ban. For night, yoru. Sayonara. Sayonara, which means goodbye. So goodbye is the phrase. Most of the Japanese people will not use sayonara. Sayonara is being used only when you are not going to see the person in your life again. Only if the, only if something magic happens, then you both can meet. At that time only, they'll tell sayonara. Most commonly nowadays, everybody is telling bye-bye. So that is very common. Sayonara looks a quite dramatic way of telling goodbye.
Oyasumi nasai. Oyasumi nasai, which means good night. Oyasumi, or else in a very short form, in a very casual way of telling good night, is oyasumi. It's not oyasumi. Oyasumi nasai is for the very formal way of telling good night. Next, arigato. Arigato. Arigato is like thank you. Arigato can be told to the friends or family, because that is the shorter version for thank you. And very shorter version for thank you also is there, that is domo. Domo, thanks. When you went to the hotel, when you are in the restaurant, after the waitress is telling menu o dozo, here is the menu, then immediately you can tell her domo. So it is a very simple way of telling thanks, but not in all the settings. So in very casual settings only you will tell domo. But arigato is also a casual way of telling thank you, but it is another form of telling thank you. But when you want to tell, for example, kaisatsukan, when you want to tell thanks to kaisatsukan, kaisatsukan means police officer, then you have to go with arigato gozaimasu. Arigato gozaimasu. Or you can tell in a very lengthier version like domo arigato gozaimasu. Domo arigato gozaimasu. Thank you very much. So this is for lengthier versions, is for first name basis. And the shorter versions is for your friends and family. This is the very important clue and very easiest thing also. Sumimasen. Excuse me. Sumimasen means excuse me. But sumimasen can be used for to tell thank you, sorry. Okay. So for all these things you can use sumimasen. Sumimasen, for example, you want to ask the route to or way to railway station. So railway station in Japanese we call it as eki. So you want to call someone. You don't know their name or anything. What you will call in English? Excuse me. The same thing in Japan also, you just call them as sumimasen, means excuse me. Sumimasen, eki wa doko desu ka? So, excuse me, where is the train station? Okay, eki wa doko desu ka? So, that is excuse me. For example, in the train, you accidentally stepped on someone's foot. Then you can immediately tell, sumimasen, I'm sorry. Then the other person will reply, iye, it's okay. So these are very, very important survival phrases. And let's see some of the interesting survival phrases. So we have these four phrases are very, very interesting and important also. For example, you are living in Japan along with your Japanese friends. You are leaving the home. Then you can tell like itekimasu, means I'll go and come back. And the person inside the home will tell itterashai, please go and come back. When you return to the home, then you can tell tadaima. Then the other person will tell tadaima means I'm home. Then the family or friends inside the home will tell you okaeri nasai, welcome home. Okay, these four phrases are very, very important. The first phrase is itekimasu, I'll go and come back. Iterashai, please go and come back. Tadaima, I'm home. Okaeri nasai, welcome home. And next, so these are four phrases, these are in one set. And next two phrases are, that is, the phrase is being used before taking the meal and after taking the meal. Obviously we have to thank the God for giving us the meal. So all the time the Japanese people will use these two phrases while before taking the meal and after taking the meal. So let me tell you what are those two phrases. That is, itadakimasu means thank you for the meal. This is the phrase that is been before taking the meal. Okay, before taking the meal, you have to thank the god like itadakimasu. Thank you for this meal. After finishing the meal, the food is delicious. So you have to tell thank you for this delicious food. So obviously it will be like gochiso samadeshita. Gochiso sama is delicious food. Gochiso samadeshita. Thank you for the delicious food. So you can also tell this gochiso samadeshita to the waitress. I always, when I go to Domino's in Japan, I always will tell this. After taking my hamburger, I will go to the waitress and I will tell her, gochiso samadeshita. Then she will feel very happy. Arigato. She will smile and tell me, arigato. Janne. See you. Because the next day I will go again and I will tell, gochiso samadeshita. After eating the hamburger, and she will reply me, arigato. So these things are very minute, but even though those are very emotionally connected, and the other people will like you so much. So the communication is the thing which makes them to understand what we are talking, what we are going to express to them. So that's why the language is very important. And also, we always have to pay respect to whatever the language, which gives us an empowerment, seriously, to live in a very joyful way. So let's see the jiko shokai. Jiko shokai means self-introduction. When I went to very new to Japan, because I don't know nothing, went to Japan and I went to the Nihongo class. For the first time, so my teacher asked me to give jiko shokai. I don't know what is jiko shokai. Jiko shokai means self introduction. So how I will give my self introduction is like, they taught me the very first thing is konnichiwa, hello, and they have taken me to each and every person in the class, and they have given the self introduction like. So I went to each and everyone to the class and I told the jiko shokai. So there are many people coming from many different countries. The very first thing you have to tell is hajime mashite, means how do you do? Hajime mashite, how do you do? Okay, later on I told them watashi wa Sangeeta desu. My name is Sangeeta, or I am Sangeeta. And the second thing I told to them, where do I come from? Because I am an Indian. So they are also from different countries. So I told them, Indokara kimashita. I came from India. And where do I live? Sentar kitani sundeimasu. I live near Sentarkita station. And next, I told them my likes and dislikes. Ega ga suki desu. I love watching movies. Ega to ongakku ga suki desu. I love music and watching movies. And finally, I ended up telling them, dozo yoroshiku. Onegai shimasu. So thank you very much that I'm very nice to see you. I'm very nice to meet you. And the other person replied me, Kochira koso dozo yoroshiku. I'm also very nice to meet you. So this is the way of telling self-introduction. Jiko shokai. You please practice it in your day-to-day life. If anyone tell you good morning, you will have your mind voice, right? Let's register in your mind, Ohio. Ohayo gozaimasu. When you are leaving home, itekimasu. The other person has to reply you, iterashai. When you came home again, tadaima. Then the other person will reply, okaerinasai. So this is all about. Let me conclude with one more time with a practice. Ohayo. Good morning. Ohayo gozaimasu. Good morning, but a formal way. These will comes under the questions in JLPT N5 examination, because they'll ask you like, you have met your professor in the road, on the road, in the early morning. How you will greet him? Ohayo gozaimasu. You will not greet him as Ohayo, because these are the very important etiquette we have to be learned. Konnichiwa. Good afternoon. Konbanwa. Good evening. Sayonara. Goodbye. Sayonara is finished. Oyasumi nasai. Good night. Arigato. Thank you. Arigato gozaimasu. Thank you very much. Polite way of telling thank you. Sumimasen. Excuse me. Iie. Sorry. No. And not to mention. Iie. Itekimasu. I will go and come back. Iterashai. Please go and come back. Tadaima. I am home. Okaeri nasai. Welcome. Welcome home. Itadakimasu. Thank you for the meal. That is before taking the meal. Gochiso samadeshita. Thank you for the delicious meal. Hajime mashite. Hajime mashite is like, how do you do? Dozo yoroshiku onegaishimasu. Which means, nice to meet you. So, for dozo yoroshiku onegaishimasu, the other person has to reply, kochira koso dozo yoroshiku onegaishimasu. So, this is all about the aisatsu. So, ojigi. Ojigi means bowing. Don't forget this. Ojigi, bowing. Hyogen noto. Hyogen noto means expression note. Hyogen. So, they have given some detailed explanation about Ohayo and Arigato. Let's see. Ohayo is used between friends and family members, while Ohayo gozaimasu is between less intimate acquaintances. Similarly with Arigato and Arigato gozaimasu. The rule of thumb is, if you are on the first name basis with someone, go for the shorter versions. If you would address someone as Mr. or Miss, use with longer versions. I already told you this, but this is very easy also. Ohayo is the greeting. Use it before the noon. But some people use it in a casual settings in the afternoon or even at night when they see their classmate or co-worker for the first time that day. Next, sayonara. Sayonara, there are several goodbye expressions in Japanese. Okay, let me tell you some of the goodbye expressions. So, if you are meeting your friend daily, at the end of the day, you are telling bye-bye and see you soon. Bye-bye, goodbye and see you tomorrow. Okay? Or you are not going to meet him or her tomorrow, but you will meet maybe the next week or next month. Then you will tell him or her as see you soon or see you, like this. We have these expressions in Japanese as, for example, see you tomorrow. Ja matashita. Ja matashita. Matashita. Ashita means tomorrow. Ja matashita. See you tomorrow. Or see you soon. For see you soon. Soon. Ja matane. Ja matane. Means see you soon. And you'll also tell take care at the end. Kiyotsukete ne. Ja matane. Kiyotsukete ne. Or see you.
It will be like Janne. Janne means see you. So depends. Sayonara is a, there are several goodbye expressions. I already told you in Japanese. The choice among which depends on the degree of separation. Sayonara indicates that the speaker does not expect to see the person spoken to before she turns a page in her life. Not until a new day arrives or until fate brings the two together again. It sounds dramatic and ritualistic, and its daily use is largely restricted to school children taking leave to their teachers. For example, Jamata. This is between friends expecting to see each other fairly soon. Shitsureshimasu. This is before leaving the office. This is used by employees. We have the goodbye expressions for employees that is quite different from Janne, Jamatane, or for example, bye bye. So the office employees, before you'll have many employees and you are leaving the office early to them. So you are leaving early to them. So you can tell them as Osaki ni sitsure shimasu. Excuse me for leaving early than you. So the other one will reply. The other co-workers will reply you. Otsukare sama deshita. So you have to tell them Osaki ni sitsure shimasu. Excuse me for leaving early. So your co-workers or superiors will reply you as Otsukare sama deshita. Means thank you for your hard work. So this is the way of telling goodbye for the office workers. So office is kaishain. Sumimasen. Office workers are kaishain. Sumimasen, which means sumimasen means excuse me, to get another person's attention, or I'm sorry, to apologize for trouble you have caused. Thank you, to show appreciation for what someone has done for you. Iie is primarily no. So if you tell Iie means house, so you have to stress the I. Iie means no. Is primarily no and negative reply to a question. In the dialogue, it is used to express the English phrase do not mention it or you are welcome, with which you point out that one is not required to feel obliged for what you have done for them. So, iterashai and itekimas, tadaima okaeri nasai. Itekimas and iterashai is common exchange used at home when a family member leaves. The person who leaves says itekimas, which literally means I'll go and come back. And the family member responds with iterashai, which means please go and come back. Tadaima, okaeri nasai. When a person comes home, the person who arrives home says tadaima, I am home right now, to the family members, and they respond with okaeri nasai, welcome home. So let's see the renshu. The practice session. So this first chapter in the Genki textbook is very important if you are going for the first time to Japan. Act out the following situations with your classmates. You met your host family for the first time and greet them. So for the first time, if you want to greet anyone, you have to tell them Hajime mashite. How do you do? At the end of the thing, you have to reply them as Hajime mashite. The other people will reply you. Sorry, you have to reply them Dozo yoroshiku onegai shimasu. The other one will reply you as Kochira koso dozo yoroshiku onegai shimasu. So this is the answer for the first question. It is 1 o'clock in the afternoon. You see your neighbor, Mr. Yamada. Then, what is your wish? Then you will wish them as konnichiwa, means good afternoon. You come to class in the morning, greet your teacher and greet your friends.
for greeting your teacher, Ohio. Sorry, Ohio gozaimasu, because teacher. Teacher is not very close to us, but she is a greater than our age or all the things. So, Ohio gozaimasu. You have to go for a longer versions. For greeting your friends and family, Ohio. On a crowded train, you stepped on someone's foot. Then immediately you have to tell, Sumimasen. Excuse me. Next, you dropped your book. Someone picked it up for you. Someone, because you don't know that person. The stranger in Japanese we call as Shiranai Hito. Shiranai Hito means stranger. So you have to tell them, Arigato gozaimasu. Thank you very much. Because he is a stranger. You have to go for a longer versions. It's 8 o'clock at night. You happen to meet your teacher at the convenience store. Then, so you have to tell, Oyasumi nasai. Good night. You're watching TV with your host family. It's time to go to sleep. Then it will be Oyasumi. Because host family means your family. You are leaving home. Itekimasu. You have come back home. Iterashai. You are leaving home is itekimasu. You have come back to home, which is tadaima. Please excuse me. Sumimasen. You have come back home. Tadaima. You are going to start eating. Itadakimasu. You have finished eating. Gochiso samadeshita. Next. This is a cultural note. Aisatsu to ojigi. Greetings and bowing. Japanese people greet each other by bowing, which has many other functions such as expressing respect, gratitude, and or apologies. There are different ways of bowing, ranging from small nod of head to 45 degree or bent at the waist. Because the more you bow, means the more respect you've been to the person. Generally, the longer and the deeper you bow, the more formal and respectful it appears to others. Many Japanese tend to feel uncomfortable with physical contact. Although, handshaking is being quite common in business situations, especially those involving foreigners. When meeting someone in business situation for the first time, it is customary to exchange meishi, the business cards, with small bow. Etiquette guides list of vast number of rules and pointers, but just remember that the important thing is to clearly show your respect while exchanging meishi. Means you have to bow a little and you have to take the meishi and you have to tell arigato gozaimasu. Or if you want to give your meishi, meishi o dozo. Here is my meishi. So then you have to reply them as, the other people will reply you as arigato gozaimasu with a small bowing. You also have to give your business card with a small bow. So that is very, very important while exchanging the meishi. So this is very important for the first time when you are going to Japan. Okay, my dear friends, if you have any doubts related to this topic, don't forget to put in the comment box, and I'm always will be available to answer all of your questions. Thank you very much. Domo arigato.